Hello, my fellow rockers. How are you all doing today? I hope you're doing well. That is what we have going on over here today. A couple of new pedals, and we're going to take a look at them today. That's the goal. But before we get into that, let me come back over here real quick. And by the way, that was the pedal you actually got to hear. Let's come back over here. Let's do a couple of quick hellos. First in the house this evening, Dusty Wilson, followed up by Mr. Gary Davlin. Gentlemen, hello, hello. The Dirty Knob, Sasso P, Tim Thomas, hello. Who else do we have in the house? Gary says, it's only $229. I thought it would have been more than that. Still expensive, but not compared to some of the other boutique pedals out there. I'll tell you what, I'm going to jump right into my opinion on the pedal. For $229, I think it's an outstanding pedal. So, let's see who else is in the house. We have Sasso Dirty Knobs. Grandpa Joe. Hello, Grandpa Joe. Johnny Rock. Well, that was a lot of conversation. I'm seeing the same names over and over. iKilt. Hello, iKilt. AQ Music in the house. James Norton. John Gregory. Metal Makes Me Crazy. Okay, I'm scrolling down to the bottom. So, a group... Bad Boys for you bad boys and girls out there. One of those. Start the evening with one of those. Brian from Oregon. So, yeah. So, today we are going to... By the way, are my levels okay? I didn't adjust my microphone. Levels okay? I should have asked. I always do. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. So, I busted out the Soldano. Now, that's a Hot Rod 50. That's an old one. That was actually made in... when Mike Soldano had his L.A. shop, you know, I guess it was the 80s, early 90s, he had a shop in L.A. And then he moved everything back to Seattle. Good. Okay, so the levels are good. So that's an original. Now, that's a hot rod. Now, the difference between the hot rod and the SLO is the transformers. The SLO had DeYoung. This one has, I don't know what he used in that. I want to say Mercury Magnetics, but maybe not. I don't know. But that was really the big difference between the Hot Rod and the SLO. The SLO had Hi-Fi Transformers DeYoung. I don't even know if DeYoung is still in business. I think it's no secret. I know Mike Soldano, and I knew a guy who used to work for him, Bill Sunt. Maybe some Soldano fans out there know Bill. In fact, Bill designed some of the amps. I want to say the Decatone and some other stuff. And he confirmed, as did Mike, confirmed that that's all everything in SLO minus the Transformers. And those DeYoungs were very expensive. So why am I telling you all of that? Well, getting back to here, Soldano is owned by Boutique Amplify Distribution, right? Do I have that right? They bought Soldano. This was news a couple of years ago at NAMM. And they've come out with some really cool stuff. They came out with the little mini amp, which sounded good. Of all the little mini amps, I played the Friedman and the Soldano. I like the Soldano better than the Friedman. They're both good, but I like the Soldano better. And this pedal here. This pedal is, I rarely talk about price because price goes up and down, but since you all brought it up, $229. And the reason why I hooked the Soldano up in the background was so you can hear the pedal compared to the amp. And then I have another nice pedal up over here. Hang on one second. That's the Artificial Blonde by JHS. So today you have two brand new pedals. And we're going to check both of them out. That is the goal for the evening. Pedra says, sounds good. Pacifica, hello. Rob Baker, hello. Dwight Bailey, hello. So that's the goal today. So what we're going to do, let me get some volume here. We're going to start with the pedal off. And we're going to hear what the amp sounds like. So, I'm going to kill the vocal mic. Now, I have a foot switch. You saw me. It's the little Randall foot switch, which basically toggles between the clean channel and the dirty channel on the Soldano. The dirty channel is what we're going to hear now. And then I'm going to put it on the clean channel and we use the dirt on the pedal and we could compare. So pay attention. Here is the amp with that with the pedal turned off. Let's start there. That's the amp. So you're going to watch me click the foot pedal. Now we're on the clean channel of the amp. And let's check out the pedal. I think it sounds spot on, but I want to know what you all think. Now, the reason why everything is set to noon is because I have the amp EQ'd. In fact, let me give you a quick close-up of the amp. That's kind of a little screen of what's happening there on the amp. So the only thing I did was I rolled the bass off just a hair. So to my ears, it sounded like Unity. Gary Davlin said, just ordered me one. Very cool. I'll tell you what, I think if I had a crystal ball, which I don't, I think it might be one of the hottest gifts this holiday season. By the way, I do have an affiliate link in the description of this video. So if you buy it, click on that link first. I'd be grateful every little bit that, you know, I make from those affiliate dollars goes back into the channel. By the way, also in full transparency, a boutique audio distribution, I said amplify, a boutique audio distribution, they did send this over. They asked me if I would like to check it out, and I'm like, absolutely, I'd like to check it out. I think they know I'm a longtime, loyal, devout Soldano fan. It's my favorite tone. Okay. Oh, Gary Davlin said it's his birthday, so he had no choice to buy one. Well, dude, from me to you, happy birthday. One of those bad boys for Mr. Gary Davlin. If everybody could wish Gary Davlin a happy birthday, he deserves it. It's his birthday. Wish him a happy birthday. Okay, I'm going to kill the vocal mic. Now, again, I have that Randall pedal, lower left. So when I turn the pedal off and click that pedal, that's how I'm toggling between the amp and the pedal. Listen carefully and tell me what you think. I think it sounds just like the amp. But you tell me what you think. Here we go. So, reading the comments, iKilt says, pedal sounds a smidge brighter to me. Could be. To me, it sounds a little louder. That's why I lowered that volume a little bit. But bear in mind, that volume, to me, may be compressed for you. That's how YouTube works sometimes. So, someone did say, Brian from Oregon said, pedal sounds a bit more compressed. It could be because there is a little bit of a volume difference. That might be what you're sounding. Ike says, compression is hard for me to pick up on. I would say, like, from 1 to 10, how close is it to the amp? I'm at, like, a 9. Easy. I could fine-tune it. In fact, let me do that. Let me fine-tune it to the amp. I purposely kept everything at noon, again, minus rolling off the bass a little bit. But let me fine tune it. Let's see just how close. But I would say just with the controls set at 12 o'clock without muddling around with them, I would say it's like a strong 9. You're right there. Okay? So here we go. You know what? I just realized that I didn't kill the vocal mic. My apologies. You know, if we really... By the way, what's your opinion on in terms of how Gary Davlin says very close? The reason why I was rolling the middle off was the... And this probably... You have to bear in mind, this is a pedal. That's a tube amp. Tube have different characteristics than a pedal. It will. I would say you're... Again, it's a strong 9. The amp, I don't know if this is coming across at your side there. There's that old expression about bees in a jar sound, right? We've heard that. And it sounds like the amp has a few more bees in that jar than the pedal does. The pedal is a little thicker. And you have to bear in mind, when you roll down the mids, that's why I rolled the mids all the way down, you get more bees in the jar. That's why I rolled the mids all the way down on the pedal. But even when I rolled it down, it didn't have as many bees in the jar as the amp did, which I have a feeling it has to do with how, you know, again, you're comparing, I paid $1,500. Those were new, $1,500 new back in the day. An SLO today, probably $4,000, right? So you're comparing a very expensive piece of equipment to a $200 pedal, which is pretty outstanding. And I would say I've played a lot of Soldano SLO style pedals, and this one absolutely positively comes closest. Guitar Man says, I like it, sounds really good. That's why I picked one up today. It's Sweetwater Strong 9 for sure. Yeah. Dan Evangay says, exactly, more harmonic range with the amp because it's analog. Well, I think the pedal might be analog too, I'm pretty sure. But it's the tubes. I think it's the tubes. Again, I'm not an amp designer. I couldn't tell you why. And by the way, I've had this conversation with people. Why does this sound like this? Why does that sound like that? I've actually never sat down with an actual designer where he could say, oh, it's because of this component or because of that component. But that's the pedal. So the set, and listen, here again, here's the crystal ball that I don't have. I think the price is going to go up, and I think it's going to be a really popular pedal. And like most things, I think someday it'll probably be discontinued because that's how these things work. If you like it, let's put it like this. They sent this to me to check out, which I'm very grateful. I review gear. People send me things. We all know that. But if they didn't send me this, I'd buy it. Okay? And I just think this is one of those pedals that later on down the road will be worth more than what you pay right now. That's what I think. John Gregory confirmed the pedal is analog. Okay, so the second pedal I want to share with you today, and by the way, stick around because I'm going to do something really cool with both of them, which you're not going to see on any other channel because nobody would put that pedal with the SLO. Let me do something real quick. Just give me 1 second. Hang on. Okay. So, what just happened? Okay, here we go. So, this is brand new from JHS. It's called the Artificial Blonde. It's the Madison Cunningham Artist Signature Vibrato pedal. Now, what's interesting here, there's a few things that are really interesting. Number one is the EQ knob, okay? It's also has a volume knob, and then, of course, the vibrato stuff, okay? And there's two vibratos, so you could have basically two separate vibrato settings by toggling the right button, and then the on-off is the left button on the foot switch. But that EQ and the volume could really do a lot for your tone. Let's look at it as a standalone pedal, and then I'm going to combine both to show you what I mean. Okay, so first things first. Thank you. Now, here's what's interesting. The EQ pedal really thickens up the tone. If you roll the EQ all the way to the left, it actually thickens your tone. And as you roll the EQ to the right, it thins out the tone. Listen. So, of course you could make it obnoxious, turn the speed and the depth all the way up, and you're in obnoxious territory. Yeah, let's do it. That's like the sound from the cartoons, like when the mouse gets its like tail caught, like Tom and Jerry, and like Tom, Jerry, when Jerry gets his like tail caught in the mouse trap. But I like my chorus, my vibrato, all that very subtle. I think everyone knows that at this point. So I like to put the speed down. The depth, you know, probably right around there is the setting that works for me. And that's the pedal. Now, here's what's interesting. Nice pedal. The EQ, now if I use both of these together, something really interesting happens. So let's start here. And I'm going to have to kill the vocal mic. But let me throw this bad boy on. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is, the first thing I'm going to do is mess around with the EQ a little bit. And then we're going to add a little dimension with the depth. I have to kill the vocal mic for this, though. If you could tell, but it sounds a lot thinner without that vibrato. The depth adds a little bit of dimension, and the EQ adds a little bit of thickness to it. And together, I like them a lot. One more time, with and without. And that was Rat. But listen to the right, that kind of the chug, and you'll hear it. Walter Hamill said, tightens up the game. It does. I agree. And it's interesting because I typically wouldn't think that a vibrato pedal would really complement, a gain. But I think, like everything else, if you use it in a particular way, a very subtle effect, that depth gives dimension, that EQ gives body. So, but I think it sounds really good. I think the pedal, the Soldano, is spot on. And you know what's interesting? Listen, for myself, I don't have an, and by the way, JHS did send this over. This is brand new. It's a Signature Series vibrato pedal. And, if you're into 80s rock, maybe you don't have a vibrato pedal. In fact, I'd like to ask you all a question. What songs, leave it in the comments, what songs use vibrato? By the way, don't go to Google. I already did that, and there were a lot of songs that weren't the genre. So let me rephrase that question. What songs 80s rock uses vibrato? That's the question. Let's do another one with the Soldano. Now, if I take that vibrato off, doesn't sound the same. Sounds a little thinner. I'm telling you, it's like, that's one of those pedals. You've heard me say this before. That's one of those pedals where if you have it in your, if you're not using it for your traditional vibrato, someone is going to say, guarantee they're going to be like, what's, like, that tone is very complex. What are they using? What is that? Okay? That's what that pedal is to me. We'll be right back. Brian from Oregon said, always on pedal. I agree. That is, even with the depth all the way up and the speed down. It just sounds good. Yeah, Brian from Oregon, I agree with you that it is an always on pedal. I think it just sounds good. Real subtle. And again, it's one of those, what are you using pedals, right? Amanda Coombs, hello, Amanda. How are you doing? Oh, so there's a purple version of that. Oh, that's interesting. I'll tell you what, I think they nailed it with the white. In fact, even the LED, the little lamp when the pedal is on, hang on. Oh, hold on. I didn't click it enough. That is the same color as the amp. Let me go to a full screen on the amp itself. You could see there that they even got the same color of the lamp. Which I think is pretty cool. Is the Soldano noisy? I mean, it's... I guess a little bit. I mean, not horribly noisy. Nothing is microphonic. I think it's good. I didn't see the purple version. Where is the purple version? Is that on Sweetwater? If it is, I missed it. Let's see. SLO. Nope. Let's type in Soldano. Survey says, I see the... I don't see the purple one. Let me come back to the chat. Oh, it's on reverb. Oh, that's interesting. I'm sorry. I failed to mention there is a deep button on the side. I'm going to kill the vocal mic. Let's check out the deep button. I'm going to turn the deep button off and compare it to the amp again. Keep your eye on what I'm doing. Yeah. The Great Vanzini, yes, it's an oomph button. So there used to be a few mods on Saldanos. One was the deep, I think it was a deep switch. There was like a Warren Haynes mod. There was a few mods, a deep mod, a Warren Haynes mod, and maybe a bright. There were four mods. In fact, if you look at a modded Saldano, there were like four little switches that they used to do as factory mods. Okay, let's see. I'm clicking on the reverb link. Ooh, look at that. That's pretty. Oh, that's interesting. That's actually... Hang on. Where's my Saldano? Oh. I have, you can't see it, unfortunately. Or maybe you can. Let me see. Well, it's the same color as the Digitech 2120 in the lower right-hand corner, but I have the SP77, which is below that, and it's the same color. Let me actually see if I could move the camera and show you. Hang on, my fellow rockers. Don't go anywhere. I'm gonna change the camera in real time. There it is. So it looks like that pre-order for the purple one is supposed to look like the Series 2 SP77, which you could see right down there in the rack, my rack of doom. That's looking at the, but what's interesting is the SP77 actually has no markings, so no 0 to 11. Preamp? Oh, that's funny, too. See that? It says preamp. Bass, middle, treble, and then output. But I do like it. Let me come back over here. So, yeah, the purple is nice. Kind of want both now. Oh, let me catch up on the chat. Is it there on main screen when you go onto Reverb home screen, click banner that shows it top, blah, blah, blah. I don't know what you're talking about. I did try the deep switch Guitar Man. Maybe that's an older comment. Eric Warrington, hello. Ian's Guitar Shack, hello. Janice, hello. Think of buying that little 1-watt tube by Marshall. Just not sure it will be worth it. $500 made on that? Let's see. In 1987, Mike Saldano created now the blah, blah, blah. Let's see. I'm skimming through it. I don't see where it says only 500 will be made. But they'll sell them. I'm confident they'll sell them. Hold on. Mr. Gary Davlin, I'm clicking on the your other link. Oh, look at that. Exclusive purple SLO. Oh, there it is. In addition to the dealer version of the pedal, Saldano will also be offering 500 units in a custom purple chassis that will be available exclusively on Reverb from the brand's direct shop. Cool. Very cool. Yep, you're right. 500. Yep. Quote from the page. So, my fellow rockers, that, by the way, did how did it sound? In your opinion, do you like the Soldano pedal? I do a lot. And do you like the Artificial Blonde? I do a lot. In fact, I like them together. Do you agree with me that the Artificial Blonde adds a bit of complex dimension to the sound and a little bit more thickness to the sound? What's your opinion? I'm just curious to know. I mean, I could tell you all day long what I think, but I want to know what you think. And while I read the comments, I'm going to play for a few more minutes. Gary Devlin said, sounded great tonight. Thank you. I'm sorry, I was talking to myself. Hang on, I'm going to get a little bit more volume in here. Keep your eye on the dB meter. Let's hit 100. So sorry I didn't kill the vocal mic. Hopefully you didn't lose your eardrums. We'll be right back. I could play that tone all day long. I love it. Well, my fellow rockers, that is what I have for you today. My Knees Hurt says I could make any pedal sound bad super easy. Well, listen, my fellow rockers, it's supposed to be a beautiful weekend here in New Jersey. I am going to, I'm reading some of the comments. John Gregory says, Tonkin, you are one of best. You never steer us wrong. You play with heart. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Very, very kind of you. Dan Van Jay says, sounded great. Thank you. You know, listen, anytime I demonstrate something, I don't waste your time. Is valuable. We don't get it back. I don't want to waste your time demoing something that either I didn't buy myself or that I wouldn't buy myself. And I like what I like, right? I like a certain kind of music. I like that grind and guitar tone. So if it works and it sounds good, I like to share that with you. And if it doesn't and I don't like it, I don't waste your time. I don't waste my time. So I am fortunate that I have an opportunity to share this stuff with you. And it's because of you all, because you tune in, and that's why I do this show. And I'm grateful for that. Great Vanzini says, that was good stuff right there. Oh, thank you, dude. One of those. But that's all I have for you. Like I started saying, it is a beautiful weekend here in New Jersey. I'm going to try to actually get some of those outdoor videos done that I haven't done yet because the weather has been insane. That's my goal. I'm going to try to do some outdoor stuff this weekend. James Norton says, are we going to get a chance to hear a wild audio guitar? That's a good question. Hopefully. Let me look into it. Braxel says, you're running the Soldano pedal into a Soldano amp. It is in the front end of the amp or in the effects return. It is in the front of the amp. But if you saw earlier when I, the reason why that little Randall foot switch is there is I made the amp clean. And then I put the Soldano overdrive pedal into that clean front end of the amp. Thank you, Ian's Guitar Shack. Very kind. You're all too kind this evening. Thank you. Gary Devlin says, the wildfires will finally be put to rest. Dwight Bailey, you also have a great weekend. Dusty says, show is great. Now I'm going to have to get one of those Soldano pedals. It's one of the most informative guitar channels on YouTube. So I tune in every Friday. Dude, thank you so much. You are all being so kind. I am flattered. Thank you. But that's it. The holidays are around the corner. I hope to have some real exciting things to show you real soon. Perhaps some of the most exciting stuff I've ever shared with you in the history of this channel. So tune in, hang out. Good stuff is coming. That's all I have. So my fellow rockers, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for being here. It means a lot. And I genuinely enjoy hanging out with you all, playing the guitar, showing you some gear, talking with you over the chat and all that stuff. So thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. Be safe. Have fun. I'm going to leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. And rock on. Until next time, be safe. Have fun. Play your guitar. And rock on. Take care.